Entangle Firewall simplifies network security with modular software platform, which is best, flexible, and scalable for any size of organization.
My name is Amjad Ali, and I'm enterprise IT enthusiast, digital transformation, and business intelligence expert. I have created SyncBricks to talk about enterprise IT, general IT, home lab, gadgets, tips and tricks, and a lot more. If this sounds interesting to you, hit the like button, click the subscribe, and press the bell icon. So let us continue the video.
Entangle Firewall is the next generation firewall. It is an open source unified threat management system. Though it has various paid applications where you can buy the subscription and you can take full advantage of it. But if you have limited IT resources and less budget, you can still opt for the free applications. Using Entangle Firewall, you can protect your network, filter the content using various applications, and by prioritizing the traffic and by enabling the quality of service, you can maximize the performance of your network. So Entangle Firewall appliance or the hardware depends upon the size of network or the number of applications that you want to use. Though you can buy the hardware from Entangle, but we will be using our existing hardware, which is not being used. This hardware has got two network ports. It has got 500 GB hard disk and 2 GB of RAM, and processor inside this is Intel Atom. I will be using this particular hardware for the installation. So if you have old PC, 2 GB RAM, 60 GB hard disk, and even Pentium or Atom processor. Hardware requirements also includes at least two network cards. So one will be for WAN and one will be for LAN. So you are all set to install. So let us begin the installation process. So first of all, you need to create your free account on entangle.com/cmd. So once you create your account and once you are logged in, you can see your account details. Simply go to download section and download the ISO CD image. You can download it for VMware also, but for the time being, we will download the CD image. Okay, once you download, you can burn this through your CD, or you can use a USB stick for this purpose. I use Win32 disk imager to write this to my flash drive. Okay, so we will start with the installation. Guided installation will really be simple and easy to do. Okay, now system is rebooting, so we need to wait for the system to reboot. It will reboot from the hard disk. You need to remove the CD from the system and then let it reboot. Okay, now once the operating system is loaded, it will automatically open the web browser. The basic settings of this. Once I press continue, it will take me to the next page, which will say me that thank you for choosing Entangle, and I need to agree to the license terms and conditions, and admin password I need to set up here. So I will enter the admin user ID and password here, and then select the time zone, choose the installation type. You need to choose the organization that you are working for. So I will choose other, or you can use whatever organization you are working for. So I'll choose other here. Time zone is selected. So now we will set up the network cards. So I'll be configuring the internal and external network here. So external network means that how I'm connecting with the internet. So I'm already having internet router, so I'll be configuring the IP address from that router. So I have a static IP that I want to assign it to you. So I'll be going through the static IP. Right now dynamic is already assigned, but I will go for static IP. So network mask is gonna be 16. So gateway is 172.1.2.1, and primary DNS also same. Now I'll configure the internal network. So internal network address by default is 192.168.2.1, but I'll change it to 192.168.13.1. So now I'll click next. So I will not do the automatic install because sometimes it is creating the problems. So now Entangle is ready to be configured. It says me, congratulations, Entangle is ready to be configured. First of all, I need to connect my Entangle with the command center. Here is in the same user ID password I'll enter in the appliance. So once I enter in appliance, it says that your account is configured and Entangle is ready to be configured. So here I can see the dashboards and then applications, how many applications are installed. There is no application installed right now. So I will go into configuration. First of all, the network. We have external network. So in external network, if I click edit, so I can change the IP address. I can change the gateway, DNS. And this particular interface is marked as is WAN. So this is a WAN interface. In case if I change this, then this will not be used as the gateway. I want to use this as a gateway, so I'll click on the WAN here. Now suppose if you are having PPoE, which means that so whatever user ID and password is being provided by internet service provider, so we will configure it here, we'll put it here, and if any DNS is provided by them, we'll put it there. If you are already having the router and you don't want to use the authentication here, still that is fine. And now you go to the internal interface. You will click here and you can see that the IP address for this particular interface is already configured. Here is the DHCP configuration. So I am assigning the IP addresses to all the clients who will be connected to the network. So this will be the DHCP range. So you can change it by yourself. So up to this, the configuration is okay. Now host name. So you can use Dyn DNS service, and in Dyn DNS you can configure the host name, and then for example if it is SyncBrix, and then the user ID password and host name which is configured in the Dyn DNS account. So you can do that as well. How Entangle will be accessed on the network. So you need to mention the HTTP port and HTTPS port. This is only the service of this particular Entangle device. And then port forwarding. You can configure the port forwarding here, for example web server. So my web server is here, and my web server's IP address is, for example, 192.168.13.5 suppose. So whatever traffic will be coming to Entangle WAN interface, so it will be forwarded to this particular IP address. Similarly, you can configure other ports also, and once you click save, so it will save the settings. Okay, these are the routes. So by default, these are the current routes. So routing table is updated by itself once you configure any routes here. Otherwise you can enter the static route by yourself. Now we'll go to DHCP server. Once the clients are connected on the DHCP server, you will see all the DHCP entries here. You can choose the static address, so you can assign static addresses to that. So you can click on it, will automatically get this particular IP address in a static advanced. So you can explore it by yourself. So I'm just giving you an idea here. So quality of service, it is very important that if you enable the quality of service, so you can assign that what is the speed of your network. Suppose download 50,000 kbps, which is 50 mbps, and upload is 12,000 kbps, which is 12 mbps. Suppose if this is your network speed, so then you can define the QoS rules. So here are the default QoS rules, which means that your VoIP traffic is prioritized here. It's very high. And suppose if you want to prioritize the web traffic here, these are the options that I will recommend to keep the default enabled. In quality of service, I have already mentioned you. So access rules. So first of all, first condition is block all, which means that everything is blocked to this particular firewall. These are the rules which are not defined in the firewall, but these are defined in the access rules. So firewall is an application where you can do various configurations that I'll explain you later in the application part. But here are these applications which are by default enabled. Now for example, ping is allowed here, so ICMP protocol is enabled here. In case if you want to disable ping, so you can disable the ping here. So the ping to this particular server will not be allowed. So this way you can disable these default ports which are by default opened while we do the installation for the first time. Okay, now we'll go to troubleshoot section here. Troubleshoot section means that if you want to test whether your Entangle is connected with the internet or if there is any connectivity issues, so you can just click on run test, so it will check test is successful. So this is done here, and then you can do the ping test here. For example, if I want to browse a particular website to make sure my network is connected here, so it is giving me ping response. So from here on the gateway itself I can check whether my network is connecting. DNS test I can do here. For example, if I do google.com, it will run the DNS test and it will give me that what are the name servers for this. And connection test, for example, if you want to check whether port is open or closed, so run test, so it will open that port, test is completed and port is open. So if you go to, for example, port 21, so we want to check if the port is open or closed, so connection refused. So this way you can do the connection test. So for trace route also you can do it to google.com to see. So in network section, this is all about network section. In configuration, the administration part. So in administration part, default user ID is admin. The email address is this that we configured. You can add multiple users here. So this is the second person here who is going to get the access. So if I want to change my password, so I can change my password by clicking on change password here. So certificates, if you want to configure the SSL certificate here, so if you want to enable the monitoring on another network management tool, so you can do that from here. Skins, simple gray is there, so you can change the skin. And Google, if you configure this with Google Drive, so what will happen, that there is a configuration that you want to store on the Google Drive, so the network the configuration of this server will be stored there. Now events section, once there is an alert, so what will happen, so there will be a trigger, it will send you email. So what are these email templates? These are the email templates defined, so these are by default defined, so you don't need to change it, but in case if you want to create a specific trigger rule here, so you can define that here. Okay, now we'll go to another option here, which is email. Okay, in email we will configure the outgoing email server. So send the email directly, which means that it will use Untangle's internal email server to send the email. But if you have your own email server, so SMTP server, so you can define it here. Lastly, local direct, if you want to create the user IDs and passwords to access the network, that I'll explain you in a specific section. Then in case there is a new version available, so it will check for the new version. It says that no upgrade is available. So once the upgrade is available, you can download and update the server. System, it is connected to the command center, which means that through command center I can do various operations. So I'll show you that, how I can do that. Logs, for how many days I want the logs to be stored in the server. Backup, if I want to do the backup of the configuration that I have done, I will click on backup to file, so it will download the backup. And restore, so I can simply choose restore from the file, it will restore. Okay, so this is all about system, and then you can click on about, so it will give you the UID. So through this you can renew your subscription if you have any license, so you will see the license here. Now we'll talk about the applications. So we will use all free applications to connect, protect, filter, perform and manage our network. So let us see what applications we will use in Untangle Firewall and what are the benefits of these applications. So first of all, we will talk about Captive Portal. So having network security policy is essential for the organizations to ensure that employees are aware of their responsibility. So Captive Portal helps you to ensure that employees read the policy and then connect to the network. Guests can also be given access to the internet once they read and understand the policy. So let us see how we can use Captive Portal in Untangle. So here is the web user interface of Untangle. So I will go to applications. So you can go to install apps. So first app is Captive Portal. So I will simply go to the connect section here. So here is Captive Portal. So I will download the application. So now application is downloaded. So if I go back to apps, so first application, which is Captive Portal, is configured here. So now capture rules, if I enable the capture rules, which means that all the people on the network will pass through that particular captive portal. So first of all, let us see what is the captive page. So we can have three kind of captive page. One is the basic message, which will give a message. It will look like this, that Untangle ThinkBricks Corporation and please read the network policy, continue. So the network policy will be displayed here and then they can continue. The moment they continue, they will log in to the network And first website that will open will be Syncbricks, which you have configured at redirected website. Now, basic login. So if you remember, I showed you in the settings option. In the settings, we have talked about the database, local database. So we talked about local directory here. So in local directory, you can configure, for example, this is ABC. So this is the password. So this is the local database, local directory. So in local directory, I have configured the users here. So if I go to, again, applications and captive portal. So in captive portal, if I choose basic login, so what will happen? Let me show you the preview here. I apply this. It will ask for the user ID and password. So I can simply enter that user ID and password. So I have to provide this user ID and password to all the users. Then they will, the moment they enter the user ID and password, so they will be able to log in. So then is custom. So they will get this particular message that welcome to the company and you have to contact the system administrator to get your device registered. So this way you can configure your captive portal. Now we'll talk about another application. So secure remote access is easy with Untangle Firewall. So OpenVPN can be configured to provide access to internal network, to remote users, and sites. Now we'll see how to configure the OpenVPN. So first of all, we will install OpenVPN application. So here is OpenVPN. So we'll install OpenVPN now. So there are two options in OpenVPN. So you can configure this particular installation as the server, or you can use this as client. So let us go to the applications first. So here it is, OpenVPN. Okay, now I'll configure OpenVPN as a server here. So first of all, I'll go to server and enable the server first, and I'll configure locations. For example, one location is Sharjah. I can configure two type of settings here. One is the site-to-site VPN, or another is user-to-site VPN. So first of all, I'll configure two sites here just as an example. So the network address of this site, which is configured already on the other site, is 172.3.0.0. So this is the IP address there, network address there, and 16 bits are used for the network. Another site is, for example, Abu Dhabi. And this is also network, and its network address is 172.4.0.0, and it's 16 bits are there. So now these are the two locations. So I will just simply save these two locations. Now the locations are saved. I'll create another user also here, for example, Amjad Mobile. So this is an individual client. I'll use this. Okay, now three locations are configured here, and none of the location is connected right now, and it will not be connected until I enable the server. Suppose now I'm enabling this server. The server has been enabled already. And now I want the users to receive this configuration, or I want to configure the clients to connect to this server. So I'll simply click on download, and there are three options available to download. One is that I can download this for the OpenVPN Connect app. So what is OpenVPN Connect app, in case? So this is the OpenVPN Connect app. So you can import settings into this. Or OpenVPN Connect app for Windows. So if you download this for Windows, so here it is. Download this for Windows. So I already have downloaded, so I will show you that. So here is OpenVPN Connect app, which is already connected right now. So if I can connect it directly, it will connect to the network, and it shows me the network traffic and other details. So now I can click this for the OpenVPN app, or I can click this to download the for the OpenVPN site to site configuration. Suppose I have already downloaded this this particular zip file, but all the configuration with the user certificates, with the encryption and all this is defined in this. So you don't need to worry about the configuration, but you have to transport this particular configuration in a safe manner. Either you can send it by email, or you can send it by, take it by flash disk, or you can remotely access the site through any TeamViewer or any other client, any other software, and then you can upload the configuration. So this way you can send the configuration, and then other sites will be configured as VPN. The VPN will be configured at other sites. Okay, now this configuration has been sent to Sharjah. I go to the client and I want to configure this particular server, this particular Untangle installation as a client. So I will simply click on upload, and this zip file will be uploaded here, and it will work as a client. And I can see here that one of my clients is connected to this server. So this particular site is already connected here. So this way we can send the configuration, and it is seamless. It will not create any problem. It is really very impressive. So there is another application which is Tunnel VPN. So Tunnel VPN is another easiest way to create and secure connection between internal networks and remote networks. But I will not recommend it for that. I will recommend to use only one server, which is OpenVPN. I have been using it for many years and I never faced any problem. It is quite simple and quite easy to use and install. Untangle as a gateway is a single solution that saves our money by taking malware, hacking attempts, phishing, and other threats before they reach to the users. For this purpose, I will be using these applications. So first of all, firewall. As far as network security is concerned, it is essential to draw a line between internal and external networks. Having firewall is essential where we use filters based on the IP addresses, protocols, and ports. So let us see how we can do it in the application. Okay, in order to install the applications, I will simply go to firewall, click the firewall. So the firewall application will be installed, and it will show me that it is installed already. Okay, here it is. Firewall application is enabled and it is installed. So I will go into rules here. I will show you how the rules can be defined. Okay, so there is no rule right now defined. So what I want to do, I want to block all the traffic, which is already, if we have seen it already, that to this particular network access rules. So by default, all the traffic is on this network is blocked. So I cannot remove these configurations. So these are all the configurations which are already enabled. So by default, on my network, all the traffic is blocked, external traffic is blocked. So I don't need to even define the rule, but still I can define the rule that from external to internal, whatever traffic is blocked, I can block that. Now, for example, if I want to add the new rule here, so I can add the new rule here. We can define the rule. We say that allowed access to web server, and on web server I want to allow access only to the specific port. So first of all, I will do this source interface. The source interface is any WAN, and I will pass this. So now whatever traffic comes, so it will be passed, but I don't want to do that. I will create, edit this rule, and I want to say here, put another condition here, that destination address is 192.168.13.5, which is my web server. Okay, so now it goes to 13.5, but it means that everything on 13.5 is allowed, which I don't want. I want to allow only port 80. So it will be destination port now. So destination port is 80. So now what will happen, that whatever traffic comes from any WAN interface and destination is this one and destination port is this, it will be allowed. So the moment I apply this rule, so it will be working here. Now I can put another rule here. For example, if I have any remote desktop server, Now what will happen that if any request comes to port 3389, so it will be allowed only to this particular server, because in the port forwarding it is already defined, it is already redirecting to this particular address. So that's the reason I have allowed here a rule. So there are various other rules that you can define here. The moment you have created the rules, you can export it, and then it will save as a JSON file, and then you can import it on another server if you want, or in another installation, or if you want to test and then you want to try it on another site, you can do that as well. So first we'll talk about intrusion prevention. There are thousands of signatures which are updated automatically for a variety of attacks that help in detection of attacks, including heuristic signatures of port scan that can block most of suspicious requests, and you can also monitor it effectively. Let us talk about another application, which is PhishBlocker. Email and website spoofing nowadays is very sophisticated, and it is impossible to recognize that. So PhishBlocker protects the users from phishing emails, fraudulent forming, and websites. So latest signatures are automatically updated, and you don't need to do any update or at the user end. As users at corporate network are always connected to the internet, and when they are connected to internet, there are various attacks. So therefore, network security professionals are always concerned to control what users can access, install, and use on the internet. Be it a smartphone or PC, filtering feature helps us to control rough applications, encrypted web request malware distribution points. So let us see what applications can be used to achieve this goal. So first of all, we will talk about Ads Blocker. Some of the banners ad are linked to scam and malware. Through Ad Blocker, we can easily block such ads at gateway without installing any plugin on the browser itself. So we can also create custom rules exceptions whenever needed, of course. Now we'll talk about Application Control Lite. Who doesn't know that application filtering is very important? So it is a signature-based layer 7 filtering application that helps blocking messaging, gaming, and various other applications. This is the best way to control the network bandwidth. Exceptions are of course always there, but don't forget to block peer-to-peer applications. Now we'll talk about Spam Blocker. Spam can be blocked at gateway without installing the application on the user. So before the spam reaches to the user, it can be blocked at the gateway itself using Untangle. So each user can access their own quarantine and spam folder without bothering IT staff. So another free application which is available in Untangle is web monitoring. So web categorization and analytics is crucial always. This application has billions of URLs classified from millions of domains and in various languages. Right now, I think it's 45 languages. So we can monitor the web traffic, but this application cannot control the traffic, which means that web filtering is not available here. And for web filtering, of course, you need the paid application, which Untangle has. So this is just web monitoring, where you can monitor the network, monitor the websites, and you can get the reports in the report section. So who is doing what and when on your network? Untangle has two applications. One is reports, and one is widget. The reports are database driven and can be drilled down to any aspect of the traffic. These reports are fully dynamic, interactive, and customizable. And in addition to reports, so if you want to monitor traffic on your network on real time, you can do that by using the dashboard, where you can add the common widgets and you can define your own custom widgets based on various filters. So this is all about the applications. So these are all the free applications which are available on Untangle. So I have covered only free applications, and I have not gone into detail of the rest of the applications except three that we already talked in detail. You can explore it further. I'm using Untangle for the network, but to protect the servers in virtualization platform, I'm using pfSense. To see pfSense installation, you can click the link above, or link is available in the description below. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to give me feedback, or if you have any comments, please type those in the comment section below. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you can get the notification immediately whenever I upload any video. So see you in next video. Till then, take care and goodbye.